Right, top five worst films. At number five is Maleficent. Yep, the so-called Sleeping Beauty, or the truth behind fairy tale. Yeah, it's not very good because this villain, Maleficent, her motivations are her boyfriend cut her wings off. So this is all essentially a massive strop. And she, to make things worse, the pixies, played by Imelda Staunton and all the other two, which are too annoying to remember, they're just so annoying. The CGI is horrible. And she's supposed, Maleficent is supposed to be the villain. Yes, she curses her to fill Elle Fanning's Sleeping Beauty to fall into a sleep like death. But she saves her many times before that, and then she reverses the curse afterwards. And to be honest, Elle Fanning and Angelina Jolie are the only two people who can seem like they're actors. Other people are a bit, especially the King, his Scottish accent is dreadful. And this could have worked, but it's trying to be so much like Oz the Grey and Powerful from last year. It just can't work. And are we supposed to root for the villain that is a villain 1 minute, next? Oh dear, I'm being too horrible. And this is, if you want to see this, just go watch the old Disney cartoon. That is way better than this one. And the only good thing, as I said, was Elle Fanning and Angelina Jolie, as they're the only ones who look like they can act. Yes, Imelda Staunton in this film looks like this is her first film. It's just, don't get me started on that crow. Disney, you can do so much better. Right, number four. Postman Pat the movie. Now, I watched Postman Pat when I was younger, and when I watched it, it was just a post van. There was no helicopters or multiple vehicles, just a post van. And this, why would you replace a postman with robotic duplicates? I know he's popular, but who does that? Did the people at the job, or say somebody in the X Factor worked at Asda, did they replace it with duplicates? No! And David Tennant and Rupert Grint are wasted here, and yes, I can appreciate the updated animation, but it's more like Mission Impossible than Postman Pat. I was half expecting Ethan Hunt to just pop out and shoot one of them. And that Dalek was just pointless. This was just something that should have stayed a TV show. There was nothing needed. And why does that guy have a grudge against television or Postman? It doesn't make any sense. And they're trying to make Jess like Gromit from Wallace and Gromit. You can tell what she's thinking through the expressions. And to be honest, Stephen Mangan had to come back, but the other cast, like Jim Broadbent, David Tennant, Rupert Grint and the others, what are they doing here? Why? Talk about abusing my childhood. Right, number three. Dracula Untold. This was an attempt to launch a Marvel Cinematic Universe style universe with Universal's monster franchise, which they're trying to revive. But Luke Evans and Charles Dance's Vlad the Impaler, who doesn't do any impaling, his name, and Charles Dance as the Master Vampire, they're the only good bits. Bradley Cooper was the guy who's supposed to be the, not Bradley Cooper, Dominic Cooper was supposed to be the villain. He's not very villainous, and his Turkish accent gets really close to Borag. And this can't launch a franchise. Luke Evans would have been so much better as a Dracula. Anyway, just do a straight up vampire story about Dracula. This just doesn't work, and the fact that it's set over 3 days makes it even worse. And it's a PG-13 or a 12A, which means the goriest it gets is a severed arm, so most of the battle scenes has to be cut out of the best bit. So the battle scenes look even worse, and the blood for some reason is black and oily, and not just the vampire's blood, human's blood. Charles Dance doesn't get much screen time because he's restricted to a cave, and Luke Evans Vlad is literally becoming a monster. But as this is trying to be a franchise launcher, it doesn't work, and it doesn't work as a singular movie. And the fact it's called Dracula Untold, they're just combining two characters and putting them together. It might as well be called Dracula Origins, because it's literally like X-Men Origin Wolverine to the monster franchise. It kills the franchise, and this time I don't think they're going to try and save it. They should just try again, completely reboot it. So that was Dracula Untold. Next, number 2. The Expendables 3. Yep. After 3 films, they're still trying to do the old action stars from the 80s and 90s. Make a team to fight a threat. As usual, Sylvester Stallone returns, but this time he has Arnold Schwarzenegger, Harrison Ford, Wesley Snipes, and Antonio Banderas, and Mel Gibson plays the villain, but I can actually see him being a villain. It's not, for once. But the thing that really got me the most was why they decided to put Get to the Chopper in there. I know it's Arnold Schwarzenegger, but what? And it says, get ready for one last ride in the trailer. I hope they mean it, because this franchise is long overdue. It just can't do any more great films. Its premise has gone off, and they're just trying to make it last. But it doesn't. And to be honest, this is the only films I've seen Sylvester Stallone in these days, and I'm not sure if he's trying to hold on to the one film he's certain to be in, or he actually thinks that he can make more good Expendables movies. Now, if there is an Expendables 4, hope there isn't, but if there is, he better learn from this mistakes, because it's not working anymore. It's just the same as it was the first two times, except different people. But the action is good. But unfortunately, the action can't save it. Unfortunately. So, the worst film of 2014. Now, before we start, I wanted a challenge. So, I didn't put Transformers Age of Extinction on here, because I wanted a challenge. Okay? Good. So, my challenge was to find a film worse than, or didn't put Transformers Age of Extinction on here, and I haven't, because number one is The Nut Job. I don't know what to say, because Will Arnett is in my best movie of 2014, and my worst movie of 2014. But this is basically an Ocean's 11 with animals and nuts, and it just doesn't work. The story is told completely in the trailer, and it doesn't work, because it has the cliched, the brains, the brawn. But Liam Neeson is just wasted here. Brendan Gleeson's okay here, but What is Liam Neeson doing here? He could have been doing so much else. And the humour is just... Try and make anyone else apart from 5-year-olds laugh. And for some reason, they got Psy, who wrote Gangnam Style, to be in this. Psy from Gangnam Style. It just... I wanted to enjoy this movie because I honestly thought it could have been Ocean's 11 for kids. What it is horrible, terrible, horrible, pointless Ocean's 11 for kids. And I'm not sure how old will our next character is supposed to be. But he sounds like an adult. And I don't think he is an adult. And it's just too confusing. There's no actual point to this movie. They just made it. For some reason. It's just one of those films that they had an idea, but they couldn't come up with another one, so they just went ahead with that one. It's just pointless. Completely pointless. Well, that's it. Join me next time for my Doctor Who Last Christmas episode review. And this is my worst films of 2014. Hope this year is going to be even better. But there's probably going to be some bad ones here as well. So, see you next time.